Welcome to Amazon Web Services. This is Shadab Akhtar. You are watching session 13. In this session, I'm going to cover CloudFormation. Elastic Beanstalk. In the last session, we have discussed about a CloudFormation, right? So today I want to start with Elastic Beanstalk. It is ideal for developer. This is the developer tool where developer can put directly a WAR file and rest of the thing is managed by cloud. Elastic Beanstalk service in AWS. AWS Elastic Beanstalk. With AWS Elastic Beanstalk, you can quickly deploy and manage applications in AWS cloud without worrying about infrastructure that runs those applications. AWS Elastic Beanstalk reduces management complexity without restricting choice or control. You simply upload your application and AWS Elastic Beanstalk automatically handles the details of capacity provisioning, load balancing, scaling, and application health monitoring. These all are the key points related to the Elastic Beanstalk. Elastic Beanstalk is easy to use. So it is a best example of PaaS. As we have already discussed about cloud computing models. So cloud computing models further categorize into two forms. First is service model. Second one is the deployment model. Service model further categorize into three forms. First is known as infrastructure as a service, which is more closer to traditional IT culture or local environment. And PaaS, platform as a service, it is ideal for developer without thinking about hardware provisioning and configuration kind of stuffs. Third one is SaaS, software as a service. So best example of PaaS is Elastic Beanstalk. So here we can select according to our requirement programming language. Elastic Beanstalk support Java, .NET, Go, Ruby, etc. And also support to Apache Tomcat server, IIS server, etc. Elastic Beanstalk is ideal for developer. Elastic Beanstalk is delivered at the lowest cost possible. It is used to deploy, test web application and run web application within 5 to 10 minutes. Elastic Beanstalk provide high level monitoring through a cloud watch as well as cloud trail service. Within a few minutes, it will warm up and running. So around in 5 to 10 minutes, it will be up and running. Configured Amazon Route 53. We can configure to Elastic Beanstalk through a Route 53 without a unique domain name that you can define. You can continue with default DNS name provided by Amazon, as well as you can map your Elastic Beanstalk application to your own domain name. For example, www.example.com. We can set applications. We can give a name of application and we can select a programming language. For example, a Java application and environment and an application can contain multiple environments. Code is deployed to an environment. Elastic Beanstalk support two environments. First, a single instance. Second thing is a high availability. Elastic Beanstalk is used for health notification through Amazon SNS notification service. So we can integrate SNS service, simple notification service, as we have already discussed about SNS, right? So we can get information, we can get a notification via email service, via SMS service, whatever you want. You can integrate. So we can enable to the SNS service with Elastic Beanstalk. Elastic Beanstalk support for Amazon EC2. Once you will select your environment, automatically it will launch a virtual machines and we can select EC2 types available. and load balancers. So it will support to all kinds of load balancers like classic load balancer, network load balancer, and application load balancer. And Elastic Beanstalk provide a very high kind of security through a IAM service, identity and access management. So we have a control on a Elastic Beanstalk, and we can create a user to access to the Elastic Beanstalk service. So that comes under the security and compliance, instance profiles, as well as a service roles. Elastic Beanstalk support to the Python, Java environment, .NET, Go, Node.js, Ruby, PHP. Also support to the server, IIS server, as well as Apache Tomcat server. So base use case is Elastic Beanstalk. Qualcomm is a very enterprise level of organization, and around 32,000 employees is working with Qualcomm, and they are using to the Elastic Beanstalk. So they find it is a very, very simple service, and it is very easy to manage virtual machines, load balancing, auto scaling, monitoring, and health of the applications, these kind of things. Now I just want to go back to AWS Management Console page, then I will show you how you can make an environment for the application and how you will upload your application in Elastic Beanstalk, and then how it will be run, and automatically what kind of resources will create with Elastic Beanstalk, like a EC2 instances and other resources automatically provisions. And Elastic Beanstalk, you can use your own war file. You can test your application on your dev machine or a dev environment, and directly you can upload your war file in Elastic Beanstalk. As we have discussed, if you are working with infrastructure as a service, these kind of steps you have to do your own. For example, you have to launch your virtual machine. After that, you have to set up your Java, and then you can run your Apache Tomcat. After that, in a web folder, you have to keep your WAR file, and you have to manage your application. You have to map your application's IP address with the root 53 DNS name, and you have to manage or monitoring your resources. Here directly you can upload your WAR file. Rest of the thing is managed by Amazon Elastic Beanstalk, AWS Elastic Beanstalk service. I already logged in with AWS Management Console page. Elastic Beanstalk comes under the compute service. This is Elastic Beanstalk, which comes under a compute service. I'm going to click on Elastic Beanstalk. So directly you can keep your Elastic Beanstalk according to your region. My region is a Mumbai. Here is, you can select your region, whatever you want to keep your Elastic Beanstalk. Here are a lot of options. See, this is an option to create a new application in a right hand side upper corner. We can continue with console as well as we can continue with CLI. It totally depends on you, that whatever you want to go, you can continue with AWS Management Console page as well as you can continue with the CLI, command line interface. So I want to continue with the console. Here is an option in a right hand side upper corner. Create a new application. I'm going to click on create a new application. Here it is asking for application name, description, and tag. I want to give a name here. For example, this is dev application. This is web application. Now I'm going to click on create. I'm going to click on create one now. See, it is asking for select environment here. First is a web server environment. Second one is a worker environment. I want to continue with web server environment. Run a website, web application, or web APIs that serves HTTP requests. I'm going to click on select. Create a web server environment. Here, launch an environment with a sample application. So we can continue with a sample application as well as we can continue with our own application. For example, you already tested your code in your local machine, in your laptop or desktop or dev machines. After that, when the WAR file will generate, so you can keep in Elastic Beanstalk directly. Another way, you can continue with sample application. So automatically Amazon will provide a DNS name and rest of the thing is managed by Amazon or your own code. So you can test your code on in your local machine or dev machine. After that, you can put your WAR file here as well as you can put your zip file here. By creating an environment, you allow AWS Elastic Beanstalk to manage AWS resources and permission on your behalf. Permission on your behalf means that you can create a user and you can give access to the users. For example, you are working in a team and you want to give access to your team only for Elastic Beanstalk. Directly, you can create a user. As we have already discussed, users comes under the IAM service, identity and access management. Identity and access management comes under the security identity and compliance service. In a security identity and compliance service, there is a IAM role, IAM, identity and access management. Inside IAM, we can create a user, we can create a group. For example, you are working in a team, you are a lead in your organization, or you are manager in your organization and you want to give access to your team, you can create users, a single user or multiple user, and you can keep these users in a group that is known as IAM groups. So you can keep in a group and you can give access. So automatically you can continue with new console, AWS new console, so their team can access to the Elastic Beanstalk and they can work. And if you want to integrate your SNS, some simple notification service, what is going on, you are in a root account, so you can get an information via SNS, via SES service, simple email service or simple notification service. So this is environment information. Choose the name, subdomain, and description for your environment. These cannot be changed later. So application name, as I already give, dev app. Here is a environment name. If you have your own domain name, for example, www.example.com, so you can continue with your own domain name. As well as if you are not going with your own domain name, automatically Amazon will provide a unique domain name. Through this unique domain name, you can access to your web application. You can describe about your web application here in a description tab. Description text box, sorry. So it is a base configuration. Here we can continue with pre-configured platform as well as already it is selected application code, means a sample application. For example, I want to select Apache Tomcat. So Apache Tomcat means already Java will be there, and you can select your version according to your requirement and then you can continue. So what will happen, application run on Java environment with Apache Tomcat. If you will do same kind of stuff, so in an infrastructure as a service, it is a very difficult task to install and configurations. But in Elastic Beanstalk directly, you will get environment within a few minutes. So this is pre-configured platform. I want to select here, choose a platform. It is showing a lot of options. See, these all are options, Docker, multi-container Docker, and pre-configured Elastic Beanstalk Packer Builder, Go, .NET, Java, Node.js, Ruby, PHP, Python, Tomcat. I want to select a Tomcat. And I want to continue with sample applications. And after that, once it will be available, then I will show you how you can upload your own WAR or zip file. See, this is the option zip or WAR. Here we can upload our own code if you have already tested in your local environment or in your cloud environment, whatever. But you need to a WAR file or zip file to upload here. So this is a sample application. I already select a Tomcat. It means that by default Java will be there. Okay. So for the Tomcat, prerequisite is a Java. So I already selected a Tomcat. Here is an application code, sample application. We can continue with existing version as well as we can upload our own WAR file or zip file, which we already tested. Now I'm gonna click on create environment. So now it is showing here using environment health has transition to appending. And this is related to the Amazon S3 storage bucket. So your version will be keep in S3 storage bucket for your environment data. And here, see, this is created a security group named. As we have already discussed about Elastic, IP address, public IP address, private IP address, and Elastic IP address. So this is the Elastic IP address. So it will automatically create Elastic IP address. Elastic Beanstalk service is a free service, but by default, the resource will create. For example, Elastic IP address is created here, and S3 bucket is created here, and other resources will create. Amazon will charge for these kind of resources. For example, one Elastic IP address is free in our account. Here is another Elastic IP address is creating automatically with Elastic Beanstalk. So it means that Amazon will charge for this Elastic IP address. See, this is showing here a waiting for EC2 instances to launch. So here automatically EC2 instance will launch. This is the URL. See, this is a default URL provided by Amazon. Dev app environment and showing here a detailed description. And you can, as I already discussed with you, you can continue with your own domain name. So now it is showing here added instances to your environment. See, successfully launched environment, dev app environment. This is a dashboard for application. So it is showing here a health is okay. And it is showing in a green color, right? And a running version is a sample application. So we can upload directly here also. For example, we have a WAR file or we have a zip file, directly we can upload. So I will show you Java small application, web application, which is written in a Java hybrid environment. And here is a configuration, Tomcat 8.5 with Java 8 running on 64-bit Amazon Linux 3.1.3. We can change from here and it is quite easy. Before going to hit this URL, I just want to show you what kind of resources automatically created with Elastic Beanstalk. First of all, I want to continue with a compute service, means a EC2 instance. I'm gonna click on EC2. This is EC2 management console page. Here is showing two instances. I just want to click here. And here it is showing dev environment, dev application environment. It is in running state, automatically created. See, this is the Elastic IP address. We can see this is a dynamic IP address. It is a Elastic IP address. It is showing in blue color. Let me select this environment. I want to select this environment, and now I'm going to click on here. See, it is showing here as Elastic IP address. This is the security group. So we can keep in three options, right? In a security group, there are three options. It is accessible to everyone else, and we can continue with our own. We can access to this application to only so in a AWS Elastic Beanstalk security group, we can keep in a source anywhere and custom as well as my IP address. Three options in security groups. So now I just want to go back, and I want to show you in S3. So another service is S3. I just want to click on S3. This is S3 management console page. And here is a Elastic Beanstalk. So this is the dashboard for web application. Here it is showing environment ID. This is the URL, and this is the dashboard and configuration, logs, health, monitoring, alarms, manage updates, events. So these options are available for Elastic Beanstalk. I just want to click on configuration first. This is the configuration. You can directly see the configuration software, AWS X-ray enable, rotate logs disable, and log streaming disable, environment properties. This is related to the EC2 instances. EC2 instances, by default, it is selected a T2 micro instance. And this is the ID and monitoring. So monitoring for the EC2 instance will be different, and load balancing will be different. It depends on the service. This is related to the load balancer, rolling updates and deployment, security, notification, manage updates, monitoring. I'm gonna click on logs now. So there is no log so far. Here is a health. This is the health of Elastic Beanstalk. A lot of options available in a health. Then monitoring. See, this is the 3.2% CPU utilization, 167 KB max network in, 60 KB max network out. This is related to the monitoring. Environment health, CPU utilization, network max in, network max out. We can create alarms also, as well as we can manage updates. Now I'm gonna click on this URL. This is a sample application, and it is running on a Java environment with Apache Tomcat. See, this is a URL provided by Amazon. This is the unique URL. I already clicked on dev application. This is an environment information. See, environment tier, web server, platform is a Tomcat 8.5 with Java 8 running on 64-bit Amazon Linux. And here is a running version, sample application, last modified, and URL. I'm gonna click on again this dev app environment. Now I want to upload and deploy a small web application. I'm going to click on choose file. This is a very simple code written in a Java hybrid environment, and I want to select this zip file. So it is showing here in a type zip archive. I just want to double click here. Now it is showing here example learn zip. I'm going to click on deploy. It will take a couple of minutes. After that, it will be available. So now health is okay. Now running version, you can see it is showing here instead of sample application, it is showing example learn lib2, and it is deployed on Tomcat 8.5 Java 8 running on 64-bit Amazon Linux. So this is all recent events. Environment update completed successfully. Right, this is, and a new application version was deployed to the running on EC2 instances, and deploy a new version to instance. Environment update is running. Now I'm going to click on same URL. So it is showing here a JSP page. It is very simple application, right? Here is showing a username. Let me give here a username. For example, I just want to give a name, Shadab. Okay, Bulgarian, and password I want to give a same. Let me click on login. Now it is showing here a login success. Welcome to Bulgarian. So Elastic Beanstalk provide a lot of facilities to the developer, because a developer should be focused on a code and, you know, application. They should not focus on the hardware kind of things or installing and configuration kind of things. So automatically Amazon Elastic Beanstalk provide a EC2 instances. So by default it will take micro instances. And after that, we can select according to our requirement, and we can modify to EC2 instance. For example, automatically it goes to the micro instances, right? And you can go to the EC2 management console page. And if you want to upgrade your micro instance to the large kind of instances according to your application, so you can modify from micro instance to the large kind of instances, or micro instance to the extra line large kind of instances, as well as you can upgrade your EBS Elastic Beanstalk. By default it will goes to the 8 GB of micro instance, means EBS Elastic Beanstalk, which is a disk in Amazon. So you want to upgrade from 8 GB to 100 GB or 500 GB or 1 TB, so you can upgrade. So we can upgrade types, as well as we can types of EC2 instance, right? As well as we can upgrade EBS Elastic Block Store. So for example, it will go to the general purpose, and we can modify from general purpose to the another options, right? And we can enhance the security. So there are two options here. First is security group, and second thing, we can create a IAM users. So IAM users means identity and access management. We can continue with security, identity, and complaints. Right, we can create a user, we can create a groups, we can create a roles, and we can give access to the users. We can select a programming language. So according to our requirement, for example, a Java, Python, there is a Docker, and Docker container is available, IIS server available, and Apache Tomcat. As we already discussed about a Java, I selected Apache Tomcat with Java. And according to our application, we can select an environment. So it will take around 5 to 10 minutes to be available for you, and rest of the thing is managed by Amazon. We can integrate with our Route 53 or Route 53. So if you have your own domain name, so you can continue with your own domain name, as well as Amazon will provide a domain name, a unique domain name URL. We can continue with sample example, as well as we can upload a WAR file or zip file. And we can monitor to our environment. It is quite easy to maintain application through a monitoring. So these, more than that, for example, it will goes to by default in S3 bucket. So these thing is very easy with Elastic Beanstalk service, AWS Elastic Beanstalk service. But if you want to work your own, so it is very difficult to do these kind of things. For example, you want to launch EC2 instance, so you have to select AMI, Amazon machine image, and your micro instance, and then the security group, and your EBS you will select. After that, you have to create IAM users in a both case. For example, you are working in with infrastructure as a service, so you will create separate IAM users, and automatically IAM user will not create with Elastic Beanstalk, as well as if you are working with infrastructure as a service. So platform, if you want to set up your environment, so it is very difficult task as a developer. If you are working as a developer, it is very difficult task to be managing an environment for a Java environment, because there are a lot of things, right? You have to download your Java file in your environment. After that, you will set up or install your Java environment, and you will set a path and a lot of things. And then you have to install Apache Tomcat and set up Apache Tomcat. There are a lot of things, right? And if you have your own domain name, so you will map your IP address with your domain name. In a security group, we can allow to the users. Obviously, if you are working with web application, you have to give a publicly accessible 0.0.0.0, which is a anywhere options in a source in a security groups. So if you have your WAR files, you can keep or you can upload your WAR file, and you can monitor. It is quite easy. So your data will be available in S3. It will be updated, means a version will be upgrade into a S3. Here is an option to change. I'm going to click on change. So see, it is showing here available warning. And current platform is a Tomcat 8.5 with Java 8 running on 64-bit Amazon Linux 3.1.3. So here are options to change your environment. This is the latest one, Tomcat 8.5 with Java 8 running on 64-bit Amazon Linux. Here are older version. See, 3.1.1 and 3.1.0 and 3.0.5 and 3.0.4. So these options, if you want to change without downtime, it is quite easy. And it is very difficult in infrastructure as a service. For example, you want to change your Java version. So it is a very, very difficult task. It is too much headache to change your version or Java version. So you have to stop all the tasks in this environment. In Elastic Beanstalk, there is no downtime. In a few seconds, it will be changed and upgrade and update. So your application will run. So very few, you know, downtime for your application. It is very, very good for the business. I'm going to click on cancel. And if I will click to the show alls, it will show all events. So these all are the events. For Elastic Beanstalk. Now I'm going to click on action button. In a drop down menu, you will find a lot of options. Load configuration, save configuration, swap environment URL, clone environment, and restart application server, rebuild environment, and terminate environment. I'm going to click on terminate environment. It is asking enter the name of the environment to confirm to delete. So this is the name of this environment. I just want to copy from here. And here I want to paste. So before going to delete this environment, it is showing here permanently terminate dev app environment. This action can be undone. Tier is a web server, platform is a Tomcat 8.5 Java 8 running 64-bit Amazon Linux AMI. And a version, I already uploaded a zip file and last modified. If you proceed with this action, the following will happen. Dev application environment, this is the URL, will be released. Release means it will be delete or terminate. Any additional resources associated with your Elastic Beanstalk environment will be destroyed. Means automatically, if you will be terminate or you will delete your environment, automatically EC2 instance will be terminate and S3 data will be terminate and other resources which is created, which is showing in events, all the data, all the resources will be terminate. So it is asking for confirmation. I give a name of this application. Now I'm going to click on terminate. Now it is showing terminate environment complete successfully, deleting SNS topic for environment, dev application environment, deleted a security group, deleted Elastic IP address, remove instances from your environment. And remove instances, environment health has transitioned from the info to the server. Terminate in progress and it will be deleted. You can track through events. So we have discussed about Elastic Beanstalk service, AWS Elastic Beanstalk. Elastic Beanstalk is ideal for the developer and we can select environment. We can select a Java, .NET, PHP, Ruby, Go, Python, IIS server and Apache Tomcat server environment, it will be available within a 5 to 10 minutes. And automatically resource will create, for example, EC2 will create, an Elastic IP will create, a SNS topic will create, and a load balancer will create with the Elastic Beanstalk environment. So we can continue with a sample application, as well as we can upload our own WAR file and zip file. It is enough for my side for Elastic Beanstalk. And if you have any question, feel free to ask me, please.